Be the exception.
I heard this heart-wrenching story recently, one with a critical warning and a lesson for all of us. Let me tell you what happened. My team and I had an offsite meeting with a VP of a big technology company that we are integrating into our systems. When the VP, and his name is Daniel, first walked into the room, I could tell that he was just off, maybe even upset about something. During our lunch break, he and I were seated together, and I told him what I had observed when he first arrived and asked if everything was okay. He quickly responded that, yeah, everything was great. I'm sure he didn't want me to lose confidence in him or his company, and explained it was just something that happened at home before he left in the morning. Not trying to pry, but I could tell that he was deeply troubled by it, so I'd asked if he'd mind sharing what had happened. His bright and confident exterior business mask then disappeared, revealing the hurting and heavy-hearted human being underneath. He said, "I was headed out the door this morning at 5:30 a.m. and my son Jackson came down the stairs in his PJs with a look of disappointment on his face, and he asked me where I was going. The morning time is usually our special time together. I explained that I had an early morning meeting that I had to get to. This made him visibly sad, which was like a knife stab in my heart. 'Are you going to be coming home, Daddy?' he asked, as if he weren't sure I ever would be. 'The truth is,' Daniel said, 'that I've been leaving early most mornings and coming home late most nights too. I've been putting on an average of 85 hours a week, which has been fun, mind you, and necessary, but I'm now seeing how much it's hurting those at home, which ironically are who I'm doing all this for anyway. I just don't know what to do. I feel like I've tried everything.' I could feel Daniel's pain, and I think we've all been there, right? Or maybe are even there now, wanting to be great at work, achieve our big goals, do right by your clients, your team, and by your career, but also do it in balance with being great at home for the people most important to you. No doubt, this is a struggle, particularly these days. This is when I started to share some of the insider secrets that I've picked up from some of the most successful people in the world, those that I've had the chance to meet, spend time with, and or present one of their profiles on some of my television networks or on Success Magazine that I published. During our lunch, I outlined three specific methods that I suggest Daniel apply to his life. Then, 3 months later, out of the blue, I got a call from Daniel. I thought something was wrong with our account, so I answered. He was just calling to say thank you, not for our business, but for what I shared with him during that lunch. He reported that he had been home for dinner before 6 p.m. that lunch forward, and hasn't missed one of the special morning times with he and Jackson. He told me how one night after dinner, he was on the family room floor wrestling with his two kids. He was tickling Jack when his three-year-old daughter Sophia came up and wrapped her sweet little arms around his neck and hugged his face tightly, saying, "I love you, Daddy." I could hear Daniel choking up on the other end of the phone as he finished his story by saying, "That night as we were getting ready for bed, my wife Angela said, 'I'm so proud of you. You are such a great dad.' Something she would never have said 3 months earlier. And he said, much more enthusiastically now, 'You wouldn't believe it, but my division is growing faster than ever. I've applied those methods in my office work and with my team, and we just reported the biggest month in the history of the company. It's nuts, but I'm working less and I'm having more success at the office and at home. I didn't think it was possible before, but that lunch changed everything for me. I'm having way more fun at work, achieving things I didn't think were possible, and doing it in balance with my life at home too. I cannot thank you enough.' Well, this phone call was so touching and really inspiring to me, so much so that I began to become inspired to share these same three insider secret methods with more people. And that's why I'm talking with you now. Spend a lunch hour with me, or any hour of the day that you choose, and I will share with you the same three insider methods that I shared with Daniel. I'm certain it will have the same kind of profound impact on your life. These are the same three methods that I've used to produce the life that I have now as well. This is a private invitation-only broadcast event, and I am inviting you. Oh, and it's free to attend. It's my treat. But capacity is limited and will likely cap out quickly. So I encourage you to register right away. And I really look forward to sharing these three insider secret methods with you too. And I will see you on the broadcast.